Now, Mayor Cristina, let's go back. Take us behind the scenes. How did you get this post?
I didn't apply for this post, but I received a call from President-elect Bongbong Marcos offering to me the position to lead the Department of Tourism, seeing as how the President-elect views tourism as one of the pillars of the economy that can help our country as it recovers from the pandemic and from various calamities.
Okay, and what made you decide to actually take the post? I mean, clearly you have another term as Liloan mayor, and you've done quite a lot in Liloan. I mean, I've read the executive summary of everything you've done to change Liloan. Why would you want to become tourism secretary? What made you say yes?
Well, first, as I expressed to President-elect Bongbong Marcos, I consulted with my family, namely my husband, Congressman Duke Frasco, my mother, Governor Gwen Garcia, and as well as Vice President-elect Sara Duterte and our local leaders, barangay captains and constituents in Liloan that gave me a fresh term. And from my consultations and discussions with them, everyone is in agreement that the honor of leading the Department of Tourism is one that cannot be turned down, considering that it will allow me to have a bigger platform to help more people in our country, especially considering that tourism is one of the most gravely affected industries post-pandemic. Duty to country is paramount, and this opportunity to help people in a larger capacity is one that I accept wholeheartedly.
Yeah.
Now, it's also a great honor for Cebu, with a Cebuana now being offered to lead the Department of Tourism. And it is an affirmation of all of the inroads and the accomplishments that Cebu has done, notwithstanding the difficulties of the pandemic as far as the tourism industry is concerned.
Meron po bang hiningi si President-elect Marcos sa inyo nung nag-usap kayo sa telepono for the post?
He didn't ask for anything other than my commitment to help his administration help the gravely affected workers of the tourism industry, as well as the negatively impacted tourism stakeholders. And so it is this earnest desire to effect meaningful programs for the tourism industry that President-elect Marcos sought my help on.
Okay. Now, I'm curious, of course, during the campaign, you were also Sara Duterte Carpio's spokesperson. A post, I'm assuming you'd have to relinquish soon. Have you made recommendations? Who's replacing you with that responsibility?
It's been a distinct honor and pleasure to be the spokesperson of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte, whom I truly believe will excel as our vice president and will help unite our country together with President-elect Bongbong Marcos. Yes, I will have to move on from being her spokesperson once I formally take on the position of being tourism secretary. But at the moment, I have not presented any recommendations to her or discussed that matter with her.
Okay. Now, as the incoming tourism secretary, you did say that you wanted to focus on tourism. Now, in Liloan, for example, you introduced modern and digitalized systems, even electric transport for the residents, online medical consultation. What from Liloan can you take all over the country to improve tourism?
Well, both in Liloan and in the entire province of Cebu, there is a wealth of talent from our local artists, artisans, and makers whose talents are evident in the products that they produce. And it would be wonderful to be able to shed light on these products and to give them a platform to be introduced nationally and globally. Not only that, I take with me the lessons of local governance, considering how important it is for the national government to have prior coordination with the local government in the tourist sites over which LGUs have jurisdiction. Especially now where the Mandanas ruling calls for the implementation of the devolution mandate of the local government code, and which has been interpreted in an executive order by President Duterte, it is even more imperative for the national government to coordinate with the local government in all aspects of the devolved functions, including tourism. And from our experience here in Cebu, it is only when you have very strong linkages between the local government units that you will be able to have a unified policy and an effective strategy to combat a very, very big challenge such as the pandemic and the recent calamities that we have suffered.
Okay, you talked about strong linkages. Pre-pandemic, the travel sector or tourism actually contributed 22.5% of the total economy in the Philippines. When the pandemic hit, it plunged by 80%. And tourism just gave a share of 4.8% to the country's GDP. How would you spur tourism to contribute more to the Philippine economy, especially that the incoming administration needs more revenues to fund its projects? How would you spur tourism, Mayor Frasco?
I think that having a very, very strong foundation for the industry is very important. And that means investing heavily in infrastructure as far as improving the connectivity and access to our tourist sites. So that means coordination closely with the relevant government agencies for the improvement of roads, bridges, access to seaports, airports, as well as modes of public transportation. I think that the introduction of technology and innovation is also very important, as that is what the pandemic has taught us, that you can actually continue to market your products by way of digitalization, by way of mobile applications, through online platforms, notwithstanding the restrictions of a physical contact. So providing our lesser-known tourist destinations with access through digitalization and through the introduction of online platforms that can shed light on them, I think, is also very important. President-elect Bongbong Marcos is also interested in improving the overall tourist experience, whether it's a domestic or foreign tourists, to make it convenient to come to the Philippines, to travel through the Philippines, and to stay in the Philippines. I think it's also very important to adopt a multidimensional approach to tourism, in that we capitalize not only on the beauty of our natural resources, but also on the wealth of talent of our people, as well as the products that they produce, including food, clothing, other items that could be marketable as well, both to local and foreign tourists. What the pandemic has also taught us, especially with the restrictions on travel from abroad, is that it's very important to capitalize on domestic tourism and to not be solely dependent on foreign tourism alone. In Cebu, immediately after some of the lockdowns were lifted, our hotels, our tourist destinations, even our local products were availed of by our local tourists. And we could see that there is now an ability by domestic tourists to also help sustain the tourism economy. Lastly, we've seen how negatively impacted tourism stakeholders and frontliners have been because of the pandemic and typhoons, calamities, and such. And so it's also very important to provide social protections for them
okay.
to ensure that they feel the hand of government help them, especially in times of need.
Okay. Now, clearly you haven't seen the details yet in terms of what the DOT has spent on, but broad strokes, the 2022 budget was, I think with the DOT, is something like $3.52 billion, if I'm correct. Have you checked how much has already been disbursed, released? Mayor, would you have money this 2022? Would you have some flexibility?
At this juncture, we are still in the process of transition as far as the all the documentary matters are concerned. I'm very hopeful that with President-elect Bongbong Marcos's declaration that he wishes for tourism to be one of the major economic pillars for the recovery of our country, that ways and means can be found to ensure that we will have the appropriate funding now and in the years to come to accomplish these goals for tourism. Mm-hmm.
Would you know already, Mayor, what programs would you keep from the existing DOT management? Like, for example, something simple, the theme, it's more fun in the Philippines. Are we going to see a change in that particular slogan or theme?
First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to the current leadership of the Department of Tourism, headed by Tourism Secretary Berna Romulo Puyat, as well as all of the personnel of the DOT that have helped our country sail through the difficulties of the pandemic. We're grateful for all of their hard work, and we recognize the proposals and plans for continuity. Mm. All of these plans and programs, including branding, will be presented to the president-elect, as he will be the one to set the vision for our country on all aspects, including tourism.
Okay. You talked about food tourism as being part of your agenda. Take us through that. What do you mean by food tourism? I remember Tourism Secretary Berna Puyat at the start of her term also mentioned something to that effect. But what is your vision when it comes to food tourism?
The experience of being in the Philippines and in our provinces, cities, and municipalities can be made more unique by having a multisensory approach to it. Not only to please the eyes as far as the beauty of our natural resources are concerned, but also to please the other senses such as taste, smell, and all of this. No? We have a very unique identity as far as our food in every region. And I believe that we will be able to harness the tourism potential of this by including in our tourism platforms and our tourism packages food tours throughout our regions to introduce local and foreign tourists to the distinct flavors of the many islands and regions of our country.